Today in the news, we got the RX 590, some DDR5, and some E3. Lots of letters and numbers. What's up, guys? I'm Snows, and this is your boot sequence. Before we start, let me give a quick shout out to Memory Express, the first sponsor of Boot Sequence. They're based here in Canada and offer a complete price beat guarantee, not to mention their stores in Calgary, Winnipeg, and Vancouver. They're a great place to try out all of the latest peripherals for yourself before you buy them. Check out their online shop in the link down below. All right, we have a lot of news today, so let's get started. First up, the Radeon RX 590 is out, and I mean, it performs as expected for the refresh of a refresh of a refresh. Thanks to its new 12 nanometer process, they were able to pull a little more juice out of it. It beats the GTX 1060 6GB in almost every test, with two or three exceptions. The card is pretty power hungry though. It consumes almost as much power as the 2080, which is a little concerning. Now, at a $280 price point, it's not worth it in my opinion, no questions asked. But if you consider the three free games that come with it right now, like Devil May Cry 5, The Division 2, and Resident Evil 2, then it might just be worth it. The last time I bought a GPU with free games was back in the Radeon HD 7970 days, and I've gotta say that I had hours of fun playing those games. So if you were interested in buying one of the games, this GPU might be worth it for you. Then we have the first sighting of DDR5 RAM for our desktops. SK Hynix just announced its first 16GB stick to meet the JEDEC standards, and it is built using the same process technology used for DDR4 RAM, but with changes that increased speed, density, while reducing the power consumption compared to DDR4. It's 60% faster, it uses 1.1 volts instead of 1.2, and it is based on the 1Y nanometer process node, which is something like 14 to 16 nanometer instead of 40 to 20 that we see in DDR4. We probably won't see DDR5 in our computers until the early 2020s, but it's nice to see that it's coming. One thing I noticed with this timeline is that Zen 3 will also launch in 2020. Do you think that AMD will make the jump at that time, or will we see DDR4 and DDR5 compatible motherboards within the same generation like we saw with Intel's Z170 boards? Then we have Nvidia, who addressed their failing RTX 2080 Ti cards. It seems like the problem was in test escapes. What is that? Well, a graphics card has more than a GPU. You have tons of resistors, capacitors, and traces on the PCB. Well, when one of these parts pass the initial testing but are in fact defective or just poor quality, that is a test escape. It seems like Nvidia will only take responsibility for their Founders Edition cards though, so people who bought partner cards will have to contact their AIBs to get service. Moving on, we might see something that no other thin and light computers have done in a while. LG might offer the Gram in a 17-inch variant. All we have so far is a US certification for LG models with the prefix 17 in the model number. LG is pretty consistent with having the screen size at the start of their model numbers, so I mean, that is where that information comes from. I wanted to know what you thought of this because a lot of companies that offered this form factor a few years back stopped making them. One of the most notable example is the MacBook Pro 17-inch. About a year into working at Apple in 2012, they phased it out and a lot of consumers were pretty pissed about it. Personally, I'd love to see a 17-inch variant of the Gram. The extra space might even allow for a discrete GPU to be built into the machine, and that'd be pretty cool. In gaming, it seems like E3 next year will not see Sony in its lineup. In a statement, Sony said that as the industry evolves, Sony Interactive Entertainment continues to look for inventive opportunities to engage the community. PlayStation fans mean the world to us, and we always want to innovate, think differently, and experiment with new ways to delight gamers. As a result, we have decided not to participate in E3 in 2019. We are exploring new and familiar ways to engage our community in 2019 and can't wait to share our plans with you. Oof, looks like Sony might have nothing to show this year. And you know what? I prefer them not spending the money to go to E3 and maybe invest in something else. I just hope that all of that money saved won't go into the pocket of the executives. Anyways, that is pretty much it for the news today, my dudes. Don't forget to check if the like button works, because I'm not sure. You can just click on it to see if it works, you know. You can click right here to see the latest video and right here to subscribe to the channel. It would be greatly appreciated. As always, stay frosty and I'll see you on the next video. You get the tech news with Boot Sequence. Yeah.